Happy Bicycle Day.
Greetings to our visionary friends and community in San Francisco and around the world. We're speaking to you from the psychedelic reliquary inside Entheon, Sanctuary of Visionary Art. As some of you may know, LSD has been pretty important to both Allison and I, and you could say it actually brought us together. My first psychedelic journey was at a party in Allison's apartment back in 1975 when I was 21. It was a turning point for me, and on that journey I went through a spiraling tunnel inside my head, and I saw the light of spirit. It answered every question, it cured my dark depression, and helped me find my beloved, Allison. And since that day, we've been lifelong partners.
In those years, it was dangerous to speak openly about psychedelics with others. And before meeting Alex, since my first psychedelic journey at age 17, I had been experiencing LSD in social groups, engaging in many activities. So-called recreational use was always evolutionary, revelatory, heart-opening for me. In 1971, deeply affected by Ram Dass's book, Be Here Now, I tried LSD in a way unique to me, quietly, solo, in a dark room. In that journey, illuminated secret writing floated through the air around me and hovered over my body and everything there. An agnostic until that moment, I recognized this vision as divine transmission. Integrating this mystical experience included seeking a spiritual meditation community and making art that portrayed my vision of secret writing, work whose meaning was never shared. When Alex revealed his vision of God contact in my apartment, his first LSD journey, we bonded, and I knew he was the one chosen for me.
The high points in our journeys became symbolized in our paintings. Universal Mind Lattice, now installed at the Chapel of Sacred Mirrors upstairs, depicts our June 3rd, 1976 simultaneous psychedelic journey and entry into the web of souls made of love and light that form the transcendent dimensions of being. This experience convinced us that there's a life beyond bodily death. This knowledge led us on a spiritual path to co-found an art church dedicated to community, creativity, and higher consciousness. For the past 12 years, we've joined with friends on Bicycle Day to celebrate the importance of the discovery of LSD, the opening that the experience has meant in our lives, and the rebirth of psychedelic culture. Now, we will recount the sacred story of Bicycle Day. LSD, or lysergic acid diethyl amide 25, was first synthesized on November 16, 1938, by chemist Albert Hoffman at Sandoz Pharmaceuticals in Basel, Switzerland. He was working with ergot alkaloids, searching for childbirth or headache medicines. He gave LSD to lab animals to see if it changed their heart rate or stimulated their uterus, and despite some agitation in the animals, nothing apparently happened, so it was not further developed.
5 years later, on Friday, April 16th, 1943, at the height of World War II, Hoffman had a distinct intuition of the importance of this substance. He said, "I heard the voice of LSD calling me, and never before or since have I heard such a voice." While resynthesizing LSD, he accidentally absorbed a small amount of the drug through his fingertips and discovered its powerful effects. Dr. Hoffman described what he experienced to his colleagues. "Last Friday, April 16th, I was forced to stop my work in the laboratory in the middle of the afternoon and to go home as I was seized by a peculiar restlessness associated with the sensation of mild dizziness. On arriving home, I lay down and sank into a pleasant, inebriated condition characterized by an extremely stimulated imagination. In a dreamlike state, with eyes closed, I perceived an uninterrupted stream of fantastic pictures, extraordinary shapes, with an intense kaleidoscopic play of colors. After some 2 hours, this condition faded away." End of quote.
This accidental dosage led him to plan an experiment on himself a few days later. Back at the lab at 4:20 in the afternoon on Monday, April 19th, 1943, Albert drank a solution of 250 micrograms, or 250 millionths of a gram, of LSD. No other drugs affect the mind in such tiny amounts, but Hoffman had discovered the most potent psychoactive molecule on the planet. Soon he was having the first LSD trip, but without a clue what might happen. His lab notes end at 5 p.m. as he wrote, "Slight dizziness, unrest, difficulty in concentration, visual disturbances, marked desire to laugh."
Within an hour, he wanted to leave the lab and go home because he feared he was dying. Because it was wartime and petrol was scarce, most people relied on their bicycle for local travel. On his bicycle ride home, Albert was terrified. His mind was filled with distortions of perception, yet he pedaled many miles from Sandoz Pharmaceuticals, followed by his lab assistant. That's why the psychedelic community calls April 19th Bicycle Day.
Hoffman entered his apartment and lay on the couch, and soon he felt out of his body, and he feared he was dying. So his assistant beckoned the doctor who lived next door to examine Albert. The doctor looked at his vitals and told him, "Albert, you're not dying. Your eyes are very dilated, but I think you're going to be okay." And with that, his anxiety was eased, and he recalled a mystic moment from his childhood that inspired him to become a chemist. Envisioning when he was very young and out in a meadow, he looked around in wonder at the beauty of the blooming flowers and realizing that everything was made of chemicals. And he wanted to know more about that. Thank God he listened to his inner voice that day. It opened him to becoming a catalyst of the psychedelic revolution.
From that fateful day, Hoffman shared his discovery with the world. Accelerating the fields of psychedelic medicine and culture, he continued to take microdoses of LSD throughout much of his life and understood it to be a sacred drug.
When a psychedelic angel spoke to Dr. Hoffman 79 years ago, it was a spiritually important occurrence for humanity. His discovery of the visionary properties of LSD and the active psychedelic alkaloids in magic mushrooms, which he named psilocybin and psilocin, have been tremendous catalysts for healing and consciousness transformation.
The psychedelic reliquary at Entheon is being prepared in order to honor the special relationship between sacred substances and the dimensions portrayed in visionary art. Over the years, we have collected special items and received impressive donations of psychedelic relics and ephemera. The Hoffman family generously donated Albert's black hat and his spectacles, the lenses through which he saw reality change on Bicycle Day, that are portrayed in Alex's painting of St. Albert.
Our friend Suki Barber donated this beautiful bust of Albert Hoffman that she made some years ago. Thank you, Suki. Our friend Earl Davis gave Cosm this drawing by Kat Harrison. It's her rendering of the Tassili Bee Shaman that's become a prehistoric visionary art icon. First reproduced in Terence McKenna's book, Food of Gods, Terence introduced the hypothesis of a prehistoric psychedelic mushroom cult in Africa, which left the evidence of their altered states in these paintings. The 10,000-year-old rock paintings of Tassili in Algeria show a bee shaman holding mushrooms and sprouting smaller mushrooms around the perimeter of its hive-like or mycelial web-like body. They must have known that magic mushrooms are best preserved in honey.
Discovered in nearby Algerian caves is a painted wall of mushroom-headed beings holding mushrooms, scampering along on dotted hallucinogenic hills that terminate in a strangely molecular, crystalline, geometric cluster. It has been noted that the small dotted lines between the mushroom-holding hands and the antenna on their mushroom heads indicate a subtle energetic bridge between the mushroom and the mind of the runner.
These prehistoric psychedelic cave paintings contain several archetypes that recur in visionary art. One, the fusion of plant, animal, and human elements into hybrid beings. Two, vistas of geometric forms. Three, graphic representations of subtle energies. And four, imagery of the magic mushroom itself. A visionary artist ideally strives to be a faithful witness to what has been seen by their own third eye in heaven, transcribing the wonder of the mystic state, because these are the most healing moments and may contain visual medicine for viewers. By sharing the highest visions through painting, we can provide an observatory for the beyond within.
There are now many artists from around the world dedicated to skillfully portraying their psychedelic openings, serving spirit and community through creativity, sharing the positive message that contact with the divine is a possibility for everyone. We look forward to annual exhibitions of the International Visionary Art Community in the All One Gallery at Entheon, Sanctuary Visionary Art at COSM, opening later this year. Entheon in the Hudson Valley is a collective creative offering to uplift the worldwide community. We welcome you to become a COSM member and to join us for the full moon on COSM.tv at monthly tours of Entheon and the new moon Zoom Art Church. Having a blessed bicycle day, appreciating that together we are part of an ancient transdenominational culture whose intent is the flourishing of life, joy, and love.
Greetings, everybody. So grateful to have you here to celebrate the visionary mystical experience and Dr. Hoffman's divine discovery. To commemorate this day, we've compiled a few of our favorite psychedelic animations by contemporary digital visionaries. New animation techniques and technologies have enabled artists to bring the psychedelic experience to life like never before. These creatives really nailed it. So grab your art supplies, put on your chroma glasses, get activated, and embark on a deep psychedelic journey. Stay for a closing message from Alex and Allison. I'll see you on the other side. Welcome back to Earth, my friends. Thanks for tuning in and sharing the love on Bicycle Day. Consider liking this video and following us on YouTube. The mission of COSM is to build an enduring sanctuary of visionary art that uplifts a global community. Visit COSM.org to learn more about how you can help. Back to you, Alex and Allison.
To close this Bicycle Day honoring, we'd like to share aloud Albert's message delivered on Bicycle Day 2007, when he was 101 years old, and shared widely on this date ever since. Alienation from nature and the loss of the experience of being part of the living creation is the greatest tragedy of our materialistic era. It's the causative reason for ecological devastation and climate change. Therefore, I attribute absolute highest importance to consciousness change. I regard psychedelics as catalyzers for this. They're tools which are guiding our perception toward other, deeper areas of our human existence so that we again become aware of our spiritual essence.
Psychedelic experiences in a safe setting can help our consciousness open up to this sensation of connection and of being one with nature. LSD and related substances are not drugs in the usual sense, but are part of the sacred substances which have been used for thousands of years in ritual settings. The classic psychedelics like LSD, psilocybin, and mescaline are characterized by the fact that they are neither toxic nor addictive.
It is my great concern to separate psychedelics from the ongoing debates about drugs and to highlight the potential inherent in these substances for self-awareness, as an adjunct in therapy and for fundamental research into the human mind. It is my wish that a modern eleusis will emerge in which seeking humans can learn to have transcendent experiences with sacred substances in a safe setting. I'm convinced that these soul-opening, mind-revealing substances will find their appropriate place in our society and our culture. Dr. Albert Hoffman, April 19, 2007.
May any merit generated by this discussion be offered to the benefit and liberation of all beings.
Happy Bicycle Day!